got, let me see who I'm with.
Let's ask this brother here.
Tell me about Wholesale Realestate.
Me, I'm just heard about it really.
Okay.
Get houses for cheaper, you're saying?
Okay, okay. Jam, I just know it's a good business opportunity.
You know, it's a good business opportunity.
Yeah.
More so, you can make a buyer and sell it.
Make a buyer and sell it.
Okay, you just selling contracts?
Selling contracts, I like that, selling contracts. Alright, I'm gonna go back to when I was young and. When I was young, I was like 16, 17 years old, and I was reading real estate books and I was excited. And, you know, I was like, okay, I can't wait to get out of high school, go to the bank and go apply for this loan so I can get me some houses. And that's what I did. When I graduated high school, I went to Bank of America. I'll never forget it. I was 18 years old. I didn't have much credit. I didn't even have a lot of tax returns. I think I didn't even have one tax return when I went to the bank. And I applied for a real estate loan. But before I applied, he said, young man, how old are you? I said, I'm 18. He said, you have a job? I said, I'm a busboy at TGI Fridays. He said, you have some savings? I said, I have about $3,000 saved up. He said, okay. Well, I'm looking at your credit and it's not strong enough. He said, to be honest with you, you're young. You're too young to come here and apply for a bank. I can't give you a loan to buy a house. And I was like, what do you mean? Why? I have knowledge. I read books in high school. I know how to invest in real estate. I need you to believe in me. Don't turn me down. I was getting frustrated because he looked like he was going to say no. And I was like, you know, you can't not turn me down for this loan. I've been waiting for this loan for 3 years. I'm not going to college. I'm going to be a successful real estate investor. He said, man, your dreams are big, but come back in 3 years. So with that being said, I said, you know what? There is a way for me to get involved in real estate without no money and no credit. I know it is. And so I went to an MIG meeting. I never forget. This is a real estate investors network meeting here in Memphis. Went to an MIG meeting and I met some mentors. It was a lot of them. They all done real estate full time. One real estate investor had over 100 properties. And I said, you know what, I need to go introduce myself to that man. So I introduced myself to him and I said, hey, my name is Rico. I know a lot about real estate. Let me be your eyes and ears to the market. Let me find some houses for you and you can pay me an assignment fee. An assignment fee. So, okay, all right, yeah. This is a big buyer's market. I need somebody like you. That's what he told me. And so after the meeting was over, he pulled me to the side and he gave me some paper. He gave me a sheet of paper. And he said, I want you to go home and I want you to study discounted properties. And I want you to study motivated sellers. I was like, discounted properties and motivated sellers. So I'm going to move right there. Discounted properties with motivated sellers. This is the meat and bones of wholesale real estate. Discounted properties. Why do you want to find discounted properties? You do not want to find houses that sell for retail and you want to, you know, take that retail property back to your buyer to buy. He's not going to buy it. The buyer needs a huge discount for a home. At least 40 to 50% under market value to buy. Okay? discount. And with that, with this example, that means is, if I find a house that's worth 100K, then I need to buy that house for what? I need to get that house for 50,000. Because once he acquires it for 50,000, he's gonna have a remaining 50,000 in equity to be able to resell or hold the long term, see if the market appreciates. Okay? So I had to learn, I had to It's like a science. You have to know I must find discounted properties in order for my buyer to have enough equity in that home to be able to resell and make a profit, or hold and put a tenant in there until the market appreciates. Okay? Motivated sellers. I'm only dealing with people who are motivated to sell their property. I gotta deal with the person who's lost their home to foreclosure, a death in the family, their mother probably had died and left the home in their name. That's what you call inherited property. These people are highly motivated to sell their homes. Probates, divorces, people who are going through divorces, these people are highly motivated. We don't want to find a person who's just okay and happy with selling their home, because they're not going to sell their home for a discount. They're going to find an agent or a realtor to listen. Okay? And realtors hate wholesalers. I'm going to say that they hate wholesalers because wholesalers are the ones who are going to knock the door down to find motivated sellers before they do. And what realtors do is they list properties so the market can see them. Okay? So there's more competition. So you don't want to deal with any properties that's on the MLS.